Believe it or not, atheism is actually the easiest worldview in the world to refute. It is because of this one question that we're about to uncover.
Atheism isn't a worldview, and your question isn't even relevant, but we're getting ahead of ourselves. Let's do this. Greetings, fellow space travelers. BionicDance here. We've got a new guy today, and I've never heard of him before. His whole gimmick is that he's got a Bible card game he's trying to sell, apparently. He's got a buttload of videos and 135 subscribers. If I was feeling uncharitable, I'd say that was an indicator of the quality of his content. But, you know, I won't. Anyway, he's one of those who thinks that a single question can destroy atheism. But the question is pretty stupid, and he doesn't even come close to proving a god is real. He's gonna bloviate for a while about his stupid card game, so we'll skip that and get right to the question.
By whose authority do you do these things? My friends, that is the question that only God can answer. And this is where atheism gets in a pickle. And it goes something like this. An atheist comes up to you and says, give me proof that God exists. All you have to do is say, by whose authority are you going to determine the validity of the truth claims that I present to you?
By nobody's authority. That's not even a relevant question. Proving truth claims isn't a matter of authority. Science doesn't operate on a say-so basis, and existence is a matter for science. This question is utterly meaningless when it comes to atheism, 100%.
Or, by whose authority are you demanding that I give you evidence that God exists?
Again, irrelevant question. Theists are the ones who make demands of people, like obedience to their God and to the principles of their religion. It's atheists who are asking for a truth check on those demands. By what authority should I follow your religion? By your God's authority? Show me that your God exists in order that I might know that this authority is real.
The Bible is riddled with contradictions. By whose authority are you determining what is a contradiction? And by whose authority are you placing an obligation on me to live my life in such a way that I don't embrace contradiction?
Do you want to embrace contradiction? I mean, you can if you like, but I think it's pretty chowderhead to do it. And contradiction is not determined by authority. The term describes, it does not dictate. We don't need authority to see when two claims are incompatible. It's up to you if you want to deny it and claim that they mesh perfectly. I can't stop you. I can only try to persuade you.
The God of the Bible is a tyrant. How can you believe in such an evil being? By whose authority are you claiming that the God of the Bible is immoral or a tyrant?
When we point out that the God of the Bible is a tyrant, we are, in effect, asking you your question. Assuming he even exists, by what authority does God rule over us? And you are, by asking the question back at us, declining to answer it yourself.
The atheist becomes the one who determines ultimate truth, what is logical, and what is moral. They make themselves God.
The assumption here is that only God can do these things, and that atheists are doing them. Indeed, that these have anything at all to do with atheism. I can't stress this enough. Atheism isn't like a religion. It doesn't perform the same functions, and you need to stop trying to compare the two. Imagine if someone came up to you and said that they don't listen to music, and then you say to them, ah, so you prefer Metallica over Bach then? Does that make sense to you? Because that's what you're doing when you compare atheism to religion.
You see, God is the ultimate source and standard of truth, knowledge, wisdom, goodness, justice. So, the question is, by whose authority do you do this? If it isn't God, then it doesn't matter.
You mean the God that almost certainly doesn't exist and which you cannot show exists? How much authority is there in a person who doesn't show up, interact, or speak, who for all intents and purposes isn't there? Answer, none at all.
You can answer objections with the Bible, and if people reject that, well, they're rejecting the word of God. They're rejecting the ultimate standard of truth, the ultimate source of truth.
By whose authority is God the standard of truth?
Paul the Apostle in Romans 1 verses 18 to 21 states that everyone already knows that God exists. So the job of the Christian isn't to prove God's existence to people.
Oh, well that's handy, isn't it?
The job of the Christian is to preach the word of God in hopes that the Holy Spirit will draw people into his kingdom.
Allow me to use your own words to reply.
Okay, good luck with that.
Again, I implore theists to stop trying to cram atheism into a religion-shaped box. Stop pissing into the definition until you like the flavor better. Atheists, please point out that atheism isn't like a religion. It's time to stop letting theists set the terms of the discussion based on their own assumptions. It's very important. Now before I go, a quick thank you to P. David Gonzalez for buying Alita Battle Angel off of my Amazon wishlist. Thank you very much. I haven't seen it yet, but I'm really curious. And until next time, fellow space travelers, this is BionicDance saying don't run on automatic. Instead, please, think. Do you want to embrace? Damn it. Do you want to embrace infinity? Contradiction. Gosh, why am I doing this? Again, I implore theists to stop trying to cram atheism into a religion-shaped box.
Even YouTubers need Ferraris. Please donate on Patreon.
You've got two choices. You can rate this video and share it everywhere across social media, or I can send my minions after you. Choose wisely.